What's wrong?
I'm fine.
I'm not shocked, but then it's a little disheartening, especially after losing and doing good on a diet.
Okay, Jaren, you gained 20 pounds. What happened?
Fluid.
You may think that this is water weight, but it's not. It's fat. You gained weight because you didn't stick with your diet and exercise.
I have not done any, I'm gonna tell you the honest God truth. I did cheat. I had Chinese food one day, honestly.
June, I watched you in the hospital for a month, and I see that unwillingness to change. You're always gonna be sick, because if you encounter something you don't wanna do, you say you're sick.
I respect you totally, but I'm gonna say this. You're wrong. I'm gonna tell you why you're wrong.
Okay.
Because I know this is my time to lose weight.
June can say whatever she wants. I care about her actions. I think she needs a wake-up call. The mental attitude that I see in you, that you are not letting your diseases go away, is bothering me.
Sweetheart, I'm gonna be honest. I don't agree with you where I'm holding on to a disease. No, baby, I will not agree with you with that.
If you were really serious about this, I would see evidence of that. Your walker is a good example. You don't need the walker, you want the walker. If you're serious about being active, this would be first thing to go.
I want this. I gained them 20 pounds and I'm wrong for that. I feel some of it's lymphedema in the water, but I believe I am a good candidate for you to do surgery on me, and I will be a great success for me.
Okay. I want you to undo the damage you have done in past month. Lose the 20 pounds that you gained. Give you 2 weeks.
2 weeks, 20 pounds.
You can do that.
Yes, I can.
All right. So you're going to be good?
Yes.
And you're going to be proactive?
Yes.
And you lose the walker?
Yes.
See you in 2 weeks, and you start working hard, okay?
Gotcha.
June has to make progress, and she has to do it now. Hopefully, this appointment has been a small wake-up call for her.
I'm way more focused than I ever been.
I've cut back on my eating, and I'm getting into the kitchen and helping to prepare my own food. And I'm taking some of the burden off study.
June's been pushing herself. I know she has a clear view on what she needs to stick to on her diet. She's been doing pretty good.
Before my last doctor visit, I was doing things my way, and that wasn't getting me very far. So now I'm doing the things the doctor told me.
I realize if I don't push myself, I will never lose this weight, and I'll never get surgery. When I feel like I'm about ready to give up, my motivation kicks right back in, like, uh-uh. Then my son in the back of my head is like, Ma, keep it moving. And I got a routine, and I'm gonna stick to it. I have worked so hard. I hope and pray it's enough to get this surgery. Taste it. My best one yet.
I'm seeing the doctor soon, and I'm making sure that skill shows me and him the progress I know I can make.
Hello.
Hi.
You have come down to about 60, 70 pounds since I saw you first time?
Yeah, pretty much.
Super. Any problem with your diet or anything?
Actually, no. I am doing awesome. I'm walking early in the morning, walking at night. I'm actually going down the steps. And what don't you see in front of me?
You're missing something?
Yeah, I'm missing something.
What?
The walker.
What walker?
Exactly. No walker.
I think the wake-up call made something sink in for June. She made the progress enough to show me that she's taking things seriously now. We go ahead and set you up for your weight loss surgery, okay?
Awesome, awesome.
I'm proud of you both.
Thank you.
All right, okay.
Mm-hmm.
This surgery means everything to me. I'm proud of myself, and I know my son will be proud of me. I can't wait to start getting my life back.
Since I discharged June after her bypass, she returned to hospital 3 times, claiming that she wasn't able to eat, she was getting weak, and she had a whole host of symptoms. But I examined her, there's nothing wrong. You know, you've been in and out of hospital with some symptom that was not really present, but it was present in your mind. The situation is you want something to be wrong, but something else is going on. What I recommend that we get you to see a psychotherapist to start helping you with this.
I don't want to talk to someone who doesn't know me.
This is part of your treatment. And if you don't want to follow that direction, that's not a very good sign.
Okay. No offense. I know you're good at what you do, but you're wrong.
June, let me tell you, 6 months down the road, you and I got to split because there'll be nothing I can do for you. You will lose a little weight, the progress will slow, and you start to gain weight again. Things will get worse for you after that. If you don't follow what your doctor say, and if you don't trust them, you should go see somebody else. Bite the bullet and go see the therapist. Maybe something good come out of it, right?
So, Ms. June, why do you think you're here today?
Honestly, because Dr. Nazarian wants me to come see you. He feels that I'm manifesting illnesses.
Tell me a little bit about what's been going on with you.
About 5 years ago, my 17-year-old son was killed. And I had a heart attack about a month after that.
From the stress of losing your son?
Yes.
I'm so sorry. The significance in your case of weight loss isn't just about weight and the physical. It's about loss with a capital L and the trauma you've experienced. What do you grieve the most regarding Mac?
Just what his future could have been, period. The things that I know that he wanted to do.
If you could go back to the day your son was killed, what would you do differently?
Just tell him I love him.
I can tell that you do a great deal to take care of others, but you're not as attentive to yourself and your own needs as you should be.
Yeah, I agree with that.
So I think it would be great if you kept that thought consciously at the forefront of your mind daily and not minimize your feelings or emotions.
Okay. That's the deal.
All right.
It's okay to talk a little. It made me realize that I could start this process of dealing with my pain. I'm not ready yet, but I'm seeing how not doing it has affected me and how I need to deal with everything at some point. I look forward to seeing that number on the scale every time I see the doctor now. There's a part of me that's always going to be nervous, but not like I was.
Awesome. That's good.
Just losing that much weight in a year, it means everything to me.
Hello. How are you today?
I'm good.
You see you're losing some weight? Can you tell the difference?
Yes. I feel good. Everything is looking good. When you recommended me to the therapist, I give it to you. It worked.
I had a feeling it would. June has lost over 200 pounds. I'm proud of her for going to a therapist and talking about some of the issues that she needs to deal with. You're doing well in a year time, get you down to 200 pounds, huh?
That's a good goal.
All right, June.
Thank you.
See you later.
Thank you.
Okay.
Looking back a year ago, I was confined to my home. Now I get to be out in the world. I am living life. And I'm loving every second of it.